I was peaking too early. Your lack of buddies is a little concerning. You heard the rumors, now I'm here and confirming. I made a friend in my 30s.
Welcome, ladies, gents, friends, betwixt and beyond the gender binary. Welcome to Jam Mechanics. My name is Matt. I'm from the Narcissist Cookbook. And joining me in the Jam McCabin today
is Bug from Bug Hunter, all the way in America. Thanks for coming to our show.
Let me explain Jam Mechanics. Wait, did you want to do it?
Let me explain Jam Mechanics to you. Jam Mechanics is a podcast. We are both songwriters. What we do is we get a challenge and we go away for 3 hours. We write a rough demo, put things together, come back, show them off to each other.
Yeah. Sometimes it's going to be great. Sometimes it's going to be the dumbest thing you've ever heard in your entire life. We don't know what the prompt is going to be today because we have a special guest coming in to give us our prompt. But before that happens,
We gotta get to know each other in a segment that I like to call Gotta Get to Know Each Other.
We got a whole list of questions that have been sent in by listeners, by fans, by arch enemies, designed for us to use to get to know each other, to cut right to the core. How do you get to the heart of a man, Bug?
You ask him, if you could make one movie mandatory viewing for everybody, what would it be and why? That's for Laura Denham.
One movie,
mandatory.
Right, so whenever anyone asks me a question about a movie, I always want to say Mission Impossible 3, because Mission Impossible 3 is, I'm not being ironic, people think I'm being like facetious about it, I'm not. Mission Impossible 3 is a masterclass in modern action movies, and it might be Philip Seymour Hoffman's worst performance, but it's still really good, which maybe introduces people to the wonder that is, you know, imagine me turning to you at the end of forcing you by law to watch Mission Impossible 3 and then go, hey, wasn't Philip Seymour Hoffman really pretty good in that? Wasn't he like surprisingly pretty good in that? That's his worst performance.
Oh, Matt, you literally do this to me after every show. Every single night we go back to a hotel and you force me to watch Mission Impossible 3 and you say that exact line.
RIP Philip Seymour Hoffman. Because I can't think of a better or funnier answer, I'm going to say Mission Impossible 3. It's really good. It's a really good movie. They've been trying to recapture the magic ever since.
You got a question for me?
Yeah, I got a question for you. First crush story. It says first crush story.
Who's that from?
From Cricket.
Thanks, Cricket, for trying to get the juicy 20-year-old gossip from a 32-year-old songwriter.
I don't even know if I could remember who my first crush was.
The only like thing that comes to mind, I feel like I've told a pretty
No, that's not true. I do remember. Sorry, go on.
I've told a pretty abbreviated version of a first crush story. If you listen to my song Point to Prove off of the album The Rough Draft, there's a little bit in the middle there about the time that I got this girl's AOL Instant Messenger screen name, which might mean something to you, as we're similar ages, but means very little to the Zoomers that I play shows for. They don't know about AOL Instant Messenger. Before we had phones, but we didn't have texting.
before Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone.
My friend Alex, before Alex invented the phone and showed it to me, we had AOL Instant Messenger. You had to be on your computer. And so I spent an entire summer talking to somebody on AOL Instant Messenger. And we kind of knew each other before we like just started doing that. And we talked all summer and we were just like so like smitten. And then first day of school, we get put alphabetically next to each other in our chemistry class and full on like stare straight ahead, cannot think of anything to say to this person. Was a pretty dramatic fail on my part, making that transition from smooth e-boy to real life gentleman. Is that the phrase that you're supposed to use? Is e-boy,
You know what? I'm not going to question it. I'm just going to let it. Cool. I'm just going to let it go out there and let Tumblr do what it does.
You seem to have a memory of your first crush. Do you want to talk about it?
It was a local girl, a little bit older than me, called Jenny, with fiery ginger hair, because apparently I am like genetically pre-coded to keep that ginger gene alive, because mm-hmm. I am like my current partner, ginger. Mm-hmm. The person that I was before then with, ginger. And this isn't like a choice I'm making, bug. Like, don't insinuate that you can control who you're attracted to, bug.
I'm just okay? sitting here.
Like, when I just see, apparently even as a child, when I saw red hair, I was just like, oh yeah, maybe we're related. That is the story of my first crush, and honestly, not much has changed.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Oh, because I have red hair, in case people at home don't know. Like, I am mm-hmm. a ginger human being. Mm-hmm. Although somebody the other day tried to take that away from me. Someone the other day was just like, you've got, your hair's not ginger, it's brown. And I'm like, are you trying to be kind to me right now? Or are you, like, you're taking away my identity. At my age, you cannot, the troubles that I have been through as a result of having red hair, you cannot then take it away from me mm-hmm. and invalidate that identity. I felt genuinely like attacked on a level I'd never felt attacked by before.
Yeah, I have a ginger beard. If I let it grow long enough,
it shines in the sun.
Both my brother and I, brown hair, ginger beards when they get long enough. My mom was a redhead, still is, but was too.
You inherited your mom's beard.
I inherited my mom's beard. Yes, correct. Cool. Do we want to get this going? Do we want to?
Yeah. So I really feel like Kyle is out there absolutely champing at the bit. Mm-hmm. Kyle is at the door of the Jamma Cabin right now, just smashing on it. So we gotta let's get Kyle Hodgkinson in.
For people who don't know who Kyle is, Bug Hunter is a band. We're a band. There's three of us. My best bud from college. We lived in the dorms together, Kyle Hodgkinson.
And in fact, you just posted a video yesterday mm-hmm. of the first ever performance. It's like the two of you playing, what, in a lecture theater or something?
Yes, it was the Engineers Without Borders benefit concert at my school. And couldn't believe I was asked to play it, but I was. And it was the first time I ever sang into a microphone. And so, like, literally, Kyle has been a part of, like, the Bug Hunter world, you know, for a very long time. We were best buds in college, has been our studio drummer for the last two albums, but our tour drummer basically for every show we've ever done. He's got some challenges for us.
Come on in, Kyle, door's open.
Hey, Jam Mechanics audience. I'm just here to say Jam Mechanics Castle, a great place to be.
Okay, so Kyle, you're so behind.
You're not caught up on the lore.
It's the Jamma Cabin, actually.
Okay.
So you haven't listened to the first episode yet, and it's not your fault. So Kyle, I've got an icebreaker for you, if you're willing to play with us. From Fallen, have you ever successfully pulled off an April Fool's joke or prank? If so, what was it?
Not an April Fool's, but Bug, we could talk about
the cones.
The cones.
yeah, so this was finals week, mm-hmm. freshman year. Kyle, where did we get these construction cones?
I think they were just outside our dorm.
Interesting. So you didn't steal a bunch of construction cones throughout the year?
No.
That was not something that you did? You didn't
occasionally could
just come home
me.
And just had another construction cone, and there it is in your dorm, and you had like eight of
them.
Why
would I do that?
I don't know. So anyways, we found these. No one stole them. They were just there. What did we do with those?
So the first thing we did was we put it outside one of our dorm mates' door. I think we like made a little face or something.
We put googly eyes on them, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. We knocked and ran. Mm-hmm. Much to our surprise, they opened the door and just they took the cone. Just
they did.
Adopted the cone mm-hmm. into their dorm.
And then mm-hmm. they didn't know mm-hmm. that we had a bunch more cones.
Oh yeah. And we had two more larger cones that we also put eyes on and a little note, and we knocked again.
Ran away.
And we ran.
What did the note say?
And the note...
It said, give us back our son.
Yeah! I was so hoping.
And then, they took all the cones and dispersed them through the building, but they didn't know that we mm-hmm. were hiding in another dorm nearby. We could hear their whole plan, right? So we knew what they were doing. They were going to take the cones and put them in like all the different bathrooms and all this stuff. And so as quickly as we could, we went and gathered all the cones back in all the different like places. So like almost no time had passed, right? As soon as they put one in, we were like right behind them, and we'd like take it back out again. And we took all of the cones and we put them outside their door with another note that just said, what the f*** was that about?
That's really good. I like that. No one's getting hurt.
I forgot about that. That was so funny. Mm-hmm. Cool. Kyle, mm-hmm. We asked this to everybody. What's your jam? What's a song or artist that you've been listening to recently that you want to just give a little shout out to?
My wife and I have both been very into the new Beyonce album.
Oh.
I've heard good things.
So we've been really into that. It's a good one. Check it out.
We're going to add that to our Friends of Jam Mechanics playlist that people can go find. Cool. All right, Kyle. Are you
ready to screw up our entire day?
Are you ready? Are you prepared? Yeah. So Kyle has two prompts for us. Yeah. The way that we do this is Kyle is our guest. Kyle is our prompter. Kyle is our jam consultant that is going to come on here and give us two prompts. Matt and I have to make our case for which prompt that both of us want to do. So this is not Matt picks one, I pick one. We both have to do the same prompt. We just have Kyle bring two, just so that we have a little bit more wiggle room to make sure that we kind of go into the break with something that we know that we can kind of work with. So having said that, Kyle, do you want to give us prompt one?
We're going to go on a little journey here. Okay. So what can people not get enough of these days? Obviously, Dungeons and Dragons and multiverses.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
What if we translate that into a song challenge? Mm-hmm. So there's an item in Dungeons and Dragons. Mm-hmm. Not a real one. It was created by a podcast that Bug and I both like. Mm-hmm. The item is called the Ring of Grammarian. The item lets you change one letter in a spell and change the effect of that spell.
Okay.
So like fireball, you could change it to be firewall and you make a wall of fire or protect your computer.
Got it.
challenge would be, Bug, you get to take a cookbook song.
Okay.
Change one letter from the title
okay.
and make it your own.
Okay.
Matt, you can take a Bug Hunter song, change one letter of the title, make it your own. And little game for it for you both, if you want. You don't tell each other what the song title is when you do the performance later, and you have to guess what they versioned.
Okay. All right. So we're going with the Dungeons and Dragons Multiverse Change One Letter Challenge.
See, the thing is, now I want to write a song called Booger in My Coffee.
Don't take my ideas, Matt. Don't take my ideas. cool. All right. So that is prompt one. Prompt two.
I was always a fan of the one word prompts and kind of let the artist sort of run with it. So the one word prompt I would give you both is crossover.
Crossover.
Okay.
Crossover.
Okay. So my first thought is that the Ring of Grammarian one has the risk of being gimmicky, but also I think I'd have fun with it.
I think it's only in danger of being gimmicky if we try to do a parody, right? If you change Deer McCracken to Bear McCracken and you write a song about bears that are on a plane, right? You're going to get into like a weird gimmicky thing. But depending on what you change and what you change it to, you can go with something that's very, very sincere.
That was my thought with this is like, it's, and that's part of like the game.
Yeah,
is like,
yeah.
What is the title? Doesn't have to be any connection.
Yeah.
It's not a sequel. It's not a parody.
Yeah. It's basically like come up with your own title, but here's how you come up with the title.
Yes.
Yeah. I would say I could do challenge one. I'll do that. I can do that.
Yeah. I'm down.
I'm looking at the Spotify for Bug Hunter right now.
Can I change two letters? Because I really want to change fungus into dingus.
One letter. You can't. Also, I'm assuming you can't just add a letter. You have to take a letter and put one on.
Correct.
Okay. Excellent.
Correct.
I think an additional twist to this is I want to make it difficult for you to guess what the song is.
Right. Okay.
I think I'm already planning, like, I'm not going to have this huge, title drop, you know, Good Morning Punshine.
Good one.
I'm going to try and make it difficult for you to guess what the song title is and what I bounced off of. You can do whatever you want, but I'm going to make it challenging. I'm going to make you have to take at least three guesses to get it right. Kyle, thank you for hopping on and hanging out with us and giving us a very, very creative prompt.
To add a little more lore behind this idea, we do have a little inside joke with our shows where Bug frequently writes my set lists and he will mutate the names of the songs on the set list.
What do I normally call Deer McCracken?
Can't say that here.
Yeah, sure. Go for it. Let it rip, bud. It's Jam Mechanics.
Deer Butt Cracking.
That's so good.
Friend in my 30s.
And we are back from the break. Welcome back, Matt.
Welcome.
Did you have a good time doing a Jam Mechanics?
I did have a good time doing a Jam Mechanics. I got it done in 3 hours. Mm-hmm. I got it like in right at the 3 hour mark. And then I messaged you and was just like, hey, can we not do this immediately? Because I need to get out of the house. Like, mm-hmm. I am just exhausted today. It turned out it's because I hadn't eaten in over 24 hours. So I went out. I listened to my friend Raven mm-hmm. singing in Nicky Tam's. I went and ate a 12-inch pizza in about 3.5 minutes. I feel like I could fight God right now.
You're going to go first this time. So
yeah, I'm going to go first. And you don't know what song I've chosen.
I don't know what song
you've
chosen.
So to remind people of what the challenge was, you know, for the whole like 2.5 minutes since you found out what the challenge was, we have to choose a song that the other person has written, take the title, swap out one letter in the title for one other letter, and then write a song based around that prompt. So that is what I've done.
Do you want to tell me anything about this before we go? Besides the title?
No, I'm going to hit go on this. I think I have a title for it. And we're just going to hit go and see how we feel about it.
Okay. I'll go into it blind. Let's do it. This is okay. Matt's song. I'm going to hit go in 3, 2, 1, go.
Driftwood body and razor clam keys. Sea glass petals and mica dust shimmer and shine. Say, come sing with me. I wanna break you open like a scallop shell. Figure out what makes you sound so beautiful. All I know are the simplest chords, triads, fifths, and root notes, but you make them more. Come sing with me. I wanna peer inside you with a microscope. You washed up here from God only knows where. In perfect tune, I can't bear to not understand things. But here I go once again. You think I'd have learned it by now, man. Something shouldn't be figured out, and by peeking behind every curtain you find, sometimes you see what you shouldn't, and some remedies don't need a hammer. Some mysteries don't have an answer. But when all you have is a scalpel, then everything looks like a cadaver, yeah. Driftwood body and razor clam keys. Beach piano all covered in seaweed and salt. Come sing with me. I wanna crack you open just to see your pearl. I wanna learn what makes you sound so beautiful. You washed up here from God only knows where. In perfect tune, I can't bear to not understand things.
So here I go, once again. You think I'd have thought to correct it. You can't keep the frog in dissected. By cutting the guts out of everything, all you get is blood in the carpet. And some remedies don't need a hammer. Some mysteries don't have an answer. But when all you have is a scalpel, then everything looks like a cadaver, yeah. A scalpel, then everything looks like a cadaver, yeah.
Is this song called Piano Beecher?
It's called Piano Beecher, yeah. I mean, I think it's actually called When All You Have Is a Scalpel, Everything Looks Like a Cadaver, but like...
I can't believe you call this song Piano Beecher. You silly.
It's not called Piano Beecher, okay? Silly, but yes, that was the prompt.
You silly person. You very silly.
It's insane that that's the one that like stuck with me, because I was like, Fear McCracken, that sort of sounds like something I could do. But yeah, like in the end, I was like, Piano Beecher, Piano on a Beach, something. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that. Going back and listening to that, I'm really pleased with that.
Yeah. Oh, man. So, I mean, all of Jam Mechanics has been worth it for... Some remedies don't need a hammer. Some mysteries don't have an answer. But when all you have is a scalpel, then everything looks like a cadaver. Ugh. So good. Are you kidding me?
So you don't think that line is too cheesy? Because I was really pleased when I wrote, when all you have is a scalpel, everything looks like a cadaver.
Oh,
and
so
then
good.
Afterwards, I was like...
And you also, I mean, because you used the origin of that phrase, right?
The hammer. Yeah,
you used the word hammer. There's so much like you did so many things correctly there that like I'm very impressed by one that you use like the origin of the phrase using the word hammer, but then you like twisting the phrase to be so much cooler and rhyme in a cool way, and then also then at the end you bring it back with another cool line that is also on theme with this cool thing that you've done. You think I'd have thought to correct it, you can't keep the frog and dissect it. Like you're weaving your tapestry. It's just, yeah, cool.
Yeah, the song is like, it's like weird and grimy, and like that's sort of my shit. And I'm really pleased with I'm really pleased with that. Like, if the take was better, I'd almost be like, it's done, yeah. But because I'm like so like, and I'm missing some of the notes, it's not there. But I'm really happy with that song.
Yeah. So looking at the lyrics now, you know, so you have this kind of like, you want to say, I want to break you open like a scallop shell. Later on, you say, I want to crack you open to see your pearl. That all wraps very well into this. When all you have is a scalpel, cadaver, dissect frogs.
The fairy tale in my head was this weird otherworldly piano that makes everything sound amazing. And then, but I want to break it apart to figure out how it works. And in probably in doing so, we'll destroy the piano.
Yeah, I probably didn't have the piano in my head when I heard that, because I know you do say driftwood body, razor clam keys, but you know, that is, I'm not at a piano yet. So
when you heard me go beach piano all covered in seaweed and salt, were you just like, what? Or did you that know, make, were you like, that's a metaphor?
You're just doing your thing. You're just out here just singing about things. I don't know.
You're just doing your thing, Matt. You're just painting images.
Yeah.
No, that's fair. That is what I do.
Yeah. I think now that I've heard the whole thing, I have it in my head. First listen, didn't catch the multiple references to the piano. I just thought you found a dead body on the beach and you were like, what's this?
And I'm like, oh, this dead body, I could cut it open, but then I just ruin it.
a perfect song. Yeah. Amazing.
So yeah, Piano Beecher. There
Piano Beecher, so good. What were your reject titles?
So I had Fear McCracken. I had, in my head, I was like, could I do Making Up Swords? Is that something I could
that's,
do?
That's not changing a letter.
Happiness Without a Catch.
Not a song title.
Oh, I think I was, I think I did have a band fiction written down.
I think the interesting thing about listening to this song was I was so engrossed in the search, in the word search. You know, because even in the second verse, you say, all I know are the simplest chords. And I was like, simplest words? That's your song. That's not it. But then I was like, well, is making up chords coming somewhere along here? And I think I was very distracted by the game a bit. I'm very excited to listen to that again.
Yeah, I'm really proud of that. I think that's really strong.
Yeah.
Baby teats. That's.
I don't even know if I have to edit that out or not. I think I do. I'm pretty sure I do.
Baby teats.
Leave it in the comments if I should have edited that out.
Do you want to?
Yeah, I'm happy to. So here's what I'm going to say about you, Matt. Your songs are very difficult to change one letter of and have words. I had to go to like an internet website, a thing that's like, give me a word and I'll tell you what words are like one letter off of this. Because I was having such a hard time finding a title that like spoke to me at all. I spent the first hour working on a song that did not come into fruition at all. Like I was like recording a bass part and a like piano part, and I got to 1 hour in and I abandoned it. I was like, this isn't working at all.
That's not the first time you've done that. And I'm constantly impressed because I'm like, I don't have time to change my mind. I'm locked in.
Well, this is why it took me a little bit longer. When you were like, hey, I want to go to do this thing, when I was like, I could definitely use another half an hour. And it's because I wasted my first hour on an idea that was nothing. Like I spent an hour, no lyrics, no song title. I was just like, okay, I have this thing. Let me get this going. And then eventually I'll figure it out. Never did. Went for a run. I was like, I need to like hard reset because I'm floundering right now. Went for a run, had a new idea.
I'm always so excited to hear whenever you're just like, I threw everything out, you know, like American Idiot or whatever. Like the idea behind American Idiot was they recorded a whole album and then the studio got flooded and their master tapes were destroyed. And then they recorded arguably the best album of their career, Green Day. So whenever you're just like, yeah, I spent 90 minutes of my 3 hours absolutely banging my head against the wall. And then I came up with something completely different. I'm always like, yeah, I'm so on board.
Yeah. So the thing I came up with, I'm happy with. Let's see if you are, and see if you can guess what song I jumped off of.
We're going to hit play in 3, 2, 1, play.
Dear Captain Stanley, I hope this note finds me well. I hope you're reading this tomorrow from inside my empty cell. The bars won't budge at all, and all the guards, they watch me well. Oh, Captain Stanley, I just really have to say, after I dodged you in Dubai and cleared your checkpoint in LA, I began to think that you just like to watch me get away. Which you'll be doing as soon as I get this door unlocked.
Oh shit, they found my lockpick.
Sorry, as soon as I get this bar removed.
Who installed this door?
Or as soon as I bribe this guard outside.
The guard is Captain Stanley, goddammit.
I'm finally screwed.
Who's finally screwed?
My game to lose.
It's game to lose.
I was the best there ever was at what I did.
But so are you.
I'm finally screwed.
It's finally screwed.
I have no chance.
He's got no chance.
I am the fattest, slowest rat in a castle full of cats. And it came down to freedom or to gold. I got caught cause I tried to choose both. Oh, Captain Stanley, I think you have proved your point. This staring contest through the bars won't serve a purpose in this joint. And the sniper pointed at me, well, it's certainly a choice.
You think you can make that shot from 3?
Oh, Captain Stanley, I think you seem to forget that there's a reason there's 100 million bounty on my head. All the governments have sought me, but no one has claimed me yet. So as soon as I...
Okay, all right.
Well, maybe if I...
I couldn't even reach you from here.
I'm finally screwed.
He's finally screwed.
Here comes the news.
Here comes the news.
I was the best there ever was at what I did.
But so are you.
I'm finally screwed.
He's finally screwed.
I had my chance.
He's had his chance.
Now I'm the fattest, slowest... sat in a castle full of cats. A final fatal bath forked in my robe. And I got caught cause I tried to choose both.
I have because first I thought it was good lose, and that, I mean, is it castle full of castle of cats?
It is not castle of cats. You fell for my decoy.
Yeah, I thought that you'd be putting. I was like, no. I was like, good lose, castle of cats, Captain Stanley. Okay, right. Okay. No, we can cut this out if need be, but we're gonna
we're leaving all 30 minutes in.
Dear Captain Stanley, I hope this note finds me well. I hope you're reading this tomorrow from inside my empty cell, the bar. So this is someone who's like an assassin or like a thief, and they've been captured. Oh, Captain Stanley, after I dodged you in Dubai and cleared your... something about not being able to escape. I don't know. Okay, you're cleverer than me. Fucking, I bet that there are people at home right now who are screaming in the street because actually they're listening on headphones in the street, yeah. And they're going, it's clearly the pattern or whatever. Wait. Is it Courtney? Courtney. Ghost stories. Fuck. Okay, just tell me.
Can I give you a hint?
Yeah, you can tell me.
Listen.
Give me a hint.
Listen back to the last 10 seconds. I think you can get it.
Back to the last 10 seconds.
Last 10 seconds.
Okay. Right. Okay.
In my robe, and I got caught because I tried to choose both.
I got caught because I tried to choose both. No, I have no idea.
A lot of emphasis on that word, on that last word of the song.
Choose both. Goth. I'm terrible at anagrams is the thing. Okay, right. Both. bots.
I love this so much. Hey, Matt, what was your first album called?
Oh, fuck. What the fuck? Really? You just went, you were like, moth.
Both.
Really? That's so... Oh, okay, yeah, you got him, me, I guess. You know, I don't think I would have... Again, you could have locked me in a prison cell. I don't think I would have gotten that in a million years.
I'm so pleased with myself right now.
I love that. That, I think, might be your... Like, you've found yourself... In Jam Mechanics, at least, I don't know if you do an awful lot of it on the records, or as much of it on the records, but where you're doing little skits between lines, mm-hmm. which this is my favorite one you've ever done. These are cool. My favorite little skits between lines. I love the sniper that's 3 feet away. Like, I'm just picturing this guy with like a long scope, yeah. Like a gun longer than him. He's just like point blank.
I was hoping that joke would come through because I wasn't sure if that would play. So I was very pleased that you laughed at that.
And what a story. Like that, you really did that Bug Hunter magic again of being like, hey, here's an incredibly dumb song, but like this is a story. I care about this person. I care about the sniper. What's going to happen? Mm-hmm. It came down to freedom or to gold. I got caught because I tried to choose both. Mm-hmm. So he couldn't withstand mm-hmm. the temptation.
Yeah. I was trying to set up that there was at some point a choice where he could have gotten away, but he would have had to give up his bounty or whatever it is.
Yeah.
And he tried, he got greedy and that was his downfall.
Are there any other red herrings in there?
No, just the Castle of Cats.
Okay.
Yeah. I thought this was fun. I had a lot of fun making it. Recording this was very reminiscent of how I recorded A Bedtime Story, which has a lot of different voices in the background and just kind of like one taking whatever comes to my head in like the gaps. And that's how I ended up with that segment of A Bedtime Story where I'm like, boo, you're not going to leave that in. I'm leaving it in. I just did that.
No, people love it.
Yeah.
It's so good. It's like such a good, and it really fits with your style. Like one of my favorite bands growing up was Real Big Fish, and they were very good at making it sound like there was a party going on in the studio. Mm-hmm. Like they would just call, like, I think in the background of most of their songs would be some sort of just like chaos, as if mm-hmm. they were like, okay, time to lay down the chaos track. And I love that. And this taps into that for me, is it makes the song feel very alive.
Interestingly, the thing that took me almost the longest, it was about 20 minutes, was just finding the Ricochet gun sounds to put in here.
Oh, so good.
Because that was...
Is that from GoldenEye? Because it felt like it was from GoldenEye N64.
It was from a website online. And I actually, I dropped $7 on the rights to use those gunshot sounds because...
Plug. No, you can go to freesound.org.
No, because I don't want to, and I didn't know, and I found...
because I didn't want to, and I didn't know,
Yeah, it's I have a site that I use that I've used for just sound effects for just different things in my music.
Production value.
Yeah, production value. And so I went and I just... This is the one site I go to, and like there was... different cartoon Ricochet sounds that I was choosing from and wanted to make sure that they didn't sound crazy realistic. I wanted them to be more cartoony.
And you can you now use them
forever?
Royalty free.
In perpetuity. You can't though. So I have a license for one user. So don't use my gun sounds.
The next album is just going to be entirely those two gunshot sounds. Just like sampled.
Pew, 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 pew. But yes, just so everybody knows, I did spend some of my money to help bring this one to life because I thought it would be worth it for the joke. And it was.
What a great show.
This is a great show. Jam Mechanics is such a good time.
At home, what did you think? If you want to let us know what you thought of these songs, you know, if you liked them, if you didn't like them, you can send your thoughts to myass. at goaway.gov. But if you want to get in touch for any reason, you can email hello@jammechanics.com. If you want to email Bug, you can email Bug at bug@jammechanics.com. You can email me at tnc@jammechanics.com. Also, join our Discord. I think the link is going to be in the show description. And yeah, thank you so much for being on this little journey with us.
If you liked these songs or this episode, you can go to our website, jammechanics.com or bandcamp.jammechanics.com and download them for free.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they're pay what you want. So if you want to throw a little support, cover, you know, a couple of gunshot sounds that were used for this episode. Other than that, we might be on tour. I don't know the release date of this particular episode. I would guess that we are on tour at this moment. If you're listening to this and you're on the West Coast at all, Denver, Salt Lake City, Boise, and Seattle are still left to go. And then in August, we're going to hit the rest of the country, like the East Coast and the Midwest and South and all that. So look for tickets, www.bughunterbug.com. They'll all be there.
Get the hell out of our jamma cabin. We need to go to sleep.
Well, I guess it's my turn to sing us a little lullaby.
Oh, it is, yeah. Say goodnight to the people, Bug.
Well, today I wrote a really good song, and I think it's number one. And I paid $7 for royalty-free sounds of a gun.
Yeah! Get out of our cabin.
They always told me I was speaking too early. Your lack of buddies is a little concerning. You heard the rumors, now I'm hearing confirming. I made a friend in my 30s.